Hello and welcome to the channel. My name is Rob with Lilbot Dyes. Today, I'm going to take you through a somewhat new style I came up with. I'm calling it Scatter Cells. It uses a new tool that I developed. Some of you may have seen this in my Cell Dye Masterclass, but this is going to be a standalone video going over that style. And rather than just doing a disc dye, I'm going to show you guys what else I've been up to lately. I'm going to do the same style using acrylic paint on canvas, and that'll be the second half of this video. So if you want to check out the disc dyeing, you can check this out right now. And if you want to see the acrylic stuff, that'll be the second half of the video. So as usual, working with Floetrol today in these squeeze bottles. This is Floetrol mixed with pro chemical and dye. There's no oil mixed in with any of this. And I'm just laying down the bed, similar to how I did it in my double rainbow video. If you want to see more details on this style of bed, there's a link to that video in the corner of your screen now. So right now I'm just laying down stripes of colors in a sort of rainbow gradient pattern, covering up all the white base that I had. I had a white base there. And once I'm all done with that, we'll get to the swipe and I'll show you guys the swipe. Not using a swipe color on this, just gonna swipe straight down from the top of the tray. Just swiping now. I got my plastic wrap, swiping the colors over the top so that it gets nice and covered. There we go. So now that the swipe's done, I'll show you guys what we're working with. I got a tray full of this 3-in-1 silicone here, and then I've got this tool that I 3D printed. I designed and 3D printed this. And basically how this works is you dip this tool in the oil, get it nice and covered, and then you hold it over the top of the tray and you flick it so that the oil comes off of it. And it's gonna give you a nice scattered cell look that looks a lot like freeform cells, but because it's with 3-in-1, it happens way faster. Like I said, I got my tool here covered in oil and I'm just gonna give it a few flicks to get the oil to come off of it. And it scatters the oil into the tray and you get a nice random dispersion of these cells and they start to bloom very, very fast. This is a very similar look to what you'd get if you had freeform cells mixed with like silicone oil for acrylic pouring. But this has a few advantages. One is it blooms really fast. Another advantage is because it's with 3-in-1 and there's no silicone mixed in, you can take a poker like I'm about to take here and you can start poking in the spots where you want cells afterwards. So it still looks organic, but you have a lot more control about filling stuff in. And then another great advantage is 3-in-1 is amazing for producing like cells within cells. It's just, for whatever reason, the right consistency. And so you get sort of the best of both worlds. You get, like, as it develops, you get cells within cells and this sort of freeform scattered look. And it always ends up really, really well. Whereas, you know, freeform cells can sometimes be hit or miss depending on how much oil you have in your mix and things like that. So now here we go, just gonna zoom this in so you can get a closer look. This is the initial development before we even add heat, and this was done in real time. This hasn't been sped up at all. So this all happens very, very quickly. You get really great results really fast. But I'm still gonna take this tray and put it under the heat lamp and really get those cells to grow and develop. So I left this under the heat lamp for, 10 or 15 minutes, and you can really see things got a lot crazier than they were before. You get a lot more stuff blooming through from the bottom and coming up to the top. It looks really great. And this is stuff that you won't get from freeform cells that you can get from this sort of style. So now I've got a Discmania P2. I'm dropping that in there. I picked what I thought was the right spot for it. Just rolling it in there. And this will go under the heat lamp for about an hour and 10 minutes, and I'll heat it to about 130 degrees and try not to go over that. If you go over 130, you can sometimes get like tiny micro bubbles from boiling the Floetrol. And now for the big reveal. Looks, that turned out really nicely. I think I used like 16 different colors in this one. You can see every one of them. It turned out really great. So that is a great result I'm quite happy with. So now that we've got the disc done, let's take this style over to the acrylic paint on canvas. This is acrylic paint, mostly dollar store acrylic paint mixed with Floetrol. I mix it two parts Floetrol to one part paint. And I'm just laying down some stripes here. Like I said, we're gonna show off the same style, just on a different medium here. So long as you got Floetrol in there or some pouring medium, this should work out very nicely for you. One thing I love about working with the paint is you can get like glittery colors and stuff that you can't work with dye. You need to rely on the plastic having glitter and sparkles in it if you want that sort of effect. But right now I've got silver that I'm laying down there. That's going to be my swipe color. Got a big sheet of plastic wrap, just pulling that silver over the top. And now you can see that it sort of dragged quite a bit, so I'm just tilting the canvas to get a nice even coverage there. And now back with the tool. Just flicking it. And you can see once it starts, it's like immediate. And one of my favorite parts of this is just, it surprises me every time. It really doesn't get old. It's a surprise every time. And so just going to finish up doing a couple more flicks, and then I'm going to come in with a poker and sort of finish the coverage. Here we go. Got my poker. Just adding some cells in there. And this is normally how you would do chameleon cells on this stuff, is just poking the cells in with 3-in-1. But it hides the style, having it scattered on there. So now I brought the canvas over to my heat lamps. I don't think anyone else doing acrylic pouring uses heat lamps like this. This is definitely something that you would only learn doing disc dyeing first and then bringing it over to acrylic. But if you bring the heat lamp over, you can get the same way that you bloom the cells in the Floetrol for dye. A little bit of heat can make those cells just pop right out and bloom very, very nicely. So I left this underwear there for a little while. I don't really recall how long. I had my eye on it pretty closely because you can, if you do this enough, you'll get some steam coming off the top. And if you really overheat it, the oil will bloom so much that it'll bloom all the way to the canvas through all the paint. Paint's still wet, but I took it out from under the heat, and this is what it looks like. Pretty awesome. And I love how you can get silver in there. This is just a great result. I've been really enjoying all the experimenting you can do working with a new medium like acrylic and taking some of the skills I've learned disc dyeing over there. So if you haven't tried that yourself and you are someone who's done a lot of disc dyeing, highly recommend giving it a shot. It's just a ton of fun. Now this is about a week later. It takes a long time for this stuff to dry because of the amount of paint I use. And then I put a coat of about 3 coats of varnish on top just to give it a nice glossy look. And it looks awesome. I've really enjoyed working with acrylics and taking these skills over. If you're interested in getting your hands on one of those tools that I designed, you can head on over to my Etsy shop. There are two ways to get it. You can get the file to 3D print it yourself, or you can buy one from me and I'll ship it over to you. So that's what I got for you today, folks. If you liked the video, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button to see more of this stuff. I'm sure I'll bring over some more acrylic crossovers. Probably gonna do a few of those. And if you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment. I'll try and my best to answer it. But I might just point you to my Disc Dye Masterclass because it can probably answer almost every question you've got. So go head on over and take a look at that if you haven't seen it already. Until next time, folks, happy dying. Hope to see y'all later. Take care.